Hi everyone, it's Sam from Sitemate. In this video, we're going to take a look at how you can export your forms out of Dashpivot. And there's two ways of doing this. We're going to cover both in this video. The first way is when you open up a form. You'll see there's a bunch of actions in the top left-hand corner of the screen. And the option that we want to look at is this one here, Download PDF. And it will download a PDF copy of the form that we have open and all of its contents. So if we click the download button, it will open up a new tab and it will start to compile that PDF for us, combining multiple pages and all the images and things like that. And once it's ready, we get our download button, click on that, and then we can download and open that up. What's good is that it comes out on a company branded PDF. So it's got your logo up the top, information about the project, your form version control and metadata displayed up the top. And then we've got the contents of the form. So we've got all the different fields. If we have any photos linked, those will get attached at the back as well. So it's really good. Combines all that information together into the one spot. That's really handy if we want to export just the single form. But what do we do if we need to bulk export multiple forms at a time? Well, we have an option, a way of doing that. And it's accessible via the register view. So if we click on register, you'll see that we have now a row for each of our forms, and each of the rows has a little checkbox next to it. And as soon as we make a selection, you can see we have actually two download options. We have export to CSV and we have download to PDF. And I should say that you can download multiple forms at a time. You can select them individually or just bulk select everything and then perform a download. In this example, we'll just look at downloading a handful of the forms. And I'll run you through these two options. So the CSV export will give you a CSV file of this register. So if you wanted to open up this register in Excel or another spreadsheeting program, the CSV export is going to be your best bet. The only thing about the CSV export is that it can't handle any photos or signatures. So those will just be displayed as Dashpivot links in the CSV export. The PDF download actually has a few options. So the register only option will give you a PDF of just this register. So it will look like a table. It will have as many rows as forms you have selected. So if we have three forms selected, we'll have three rows in that table. And what's good is that it comes out on a big A3 PDF. So it's going to be a bit bigger than an A4 page. It'll be landscape and it will fit as many columns as it can. So that's the first option. I'm going to talk about the third option before we talk about the second one. The third option for forms only will give you an individual PDF for each of the forms that you have selected. So if we were to click this option, it will give us three PDF files and they'll come out looking exactly the same as what we saw when we exported just the one form. We'll have, just imagine that we'll have three of these files. Now the middle option is actually a combination of the first and third. So we'll get our register cover page, which will be an A3 table. It will have all of the rows for each of the forms that we'd selected. But then behind that, every page after that in the PDF will be each form that we'd exported. So let's take a look at how that works. And again, it just takes us to a page where Dashpivot in the background just has to run that, that export process. It needs to combine multiple forms together into a single PDF file. And once it's done that, we can then click download and let's take a look. So this is the cover page. Again, it comes out looking nice and professional. It's got your logo, information about the project team, the versioning, and then we've got our register or our table. So it's got three rows because we selected three forms and it's got as many columns as it can show us on the page. Now, if you have more columns in your register than what's displayed on the PDF, you might want to hide or show some of the columns or rearrange some of them to get the appropriate columns onto the page. Basically it'll show as many as it can. Now, this is the cover page. So this is A3, but then everything behind that will be an A4 page. So you can see it's a little bit smaller. And this is these are the individual forms. So this is the first site diary that we selected. And you can see it looks exactly the same as what we saw when we exported the single form. The difference here is that we've got our first site diary here, and then we have our second site diary, and then we have our third site diary as well. So we've got, in total, we've got three forms and a cover page. And so if we exported, 10 forms, we'd have 10 rows in the table and then 10 pages probably behind that in our export, because you can bulk select and export multiple at a time. A quick note on doing a bulk export, you may want to limit the number of forms that you export at a time for a number of reasons. The first being that it'll be a much shorter download time if you're downloading 10 forms as opposed to 100. And it means that the file size that you actually get out of Dashpivot is going to be a lot more practical. So if you have a PDF that has 100 pages, the size of that PDF might be quite large, especially if you have a lot of photos attached to it. And it might cause issues if you want to email that to someone because your email provider only has only accepts files up to a certain size. I think most of them are about 20 megabytes. So if you go over that, then it's not going to be practical to send that around. And it also means that if you want to open up that PDF on your computer, it's going to be a lot faster to open up a smaller file size. So what we typically recommend is batching the downloads in maybe 10 or 15 or 20 forms at a time if you're looking to get that combined register and forms export. If you're just doing the forms, it doesn't really matter as much. And if you're doing just the register, it doesn't matter at all. So just something to keep in mind. And the last thing that I'll say in this video is that while we're currently in a project team in the template section and running an export, if you have a company-wide template that's being deployed and used across all of your projects, you can access the same export functionality at a company level. So if we click on our company name, and we head to our template library, and we go to our template, our site diary template was the example that we used. This is now showing us all of the forms that use our site diary template across the whole company. So every project is listed here. And so we have the same options. We can perform a bulk select and a bulk export to CSV or to PDF. We have the same options available to us. Just wanted to make a note of that, because instead of going from project to project to project to find the forms and run an export, if you're using that template across all of your projects, you can access the export in a single place, and it's just much easier to run. So with that in mind, that concludes this video. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.